Well, what happens when there are changes in air pressure? And take a look at this. These are dots again, but I think you can see that there are two vertical columns here that represent a compression of a lot of air molecules, and that around them, there's less compression, or rarefaction, as we call them, compression and rarefaction. I'm going to use a slightly different representation, but it's basically the same thing. I think you can make the connection, but see these vertical lines below? And I've labeled them now rarefaction and compression, right? They represent those air molecules, those dots up above. And those pressure changes travel over into the ear. They go through the ear canal and then they hit the eardrum. And if we look at the figure again, that's in the time domain, again, time is on the horizontal axis, pressure is on the vertical axis, you'll see that there is a correspondence between the movement in the signal and what's depicted in the dots and the lines that represent compression and rarefaction.